Hey, it's Krista from Hilltop in the Valley, and usually I bring you guys inspiration for nurturing and nourishing your homes, and I'm going to do the same thing today, but today we're talking about einkorn, and you might have noticed that I like to do a lot of einkorn flour recipes on both my blog and on the YouTube channel. Well, today I'm going to bring you three reasons why you should not eat einkorn. So I'm not saying everyone shouldn't eat einkorn. This isn't going to take in everybody, but I do want you to know that there are certain circumstances under which you should not have einkorn. There is another blog post and video. I believe it's titled, Does Einkorn Cause Inflammation? And that one has been very helpful for people in understanding what the structure of einkorn is and why it does certain things better for people, or in some instances who shouldn't have it. But I really wanted to focus on that in this video of who should not have einkorn. And I also want to give you a little hope if you are unable to have it, that it might not be a forever thing. So I have to start off with this video by saying I am not a doctor, so you need to talk to your own medical health practitioner about einkorn if you are considering putting it into your diet, but you have certain health issues that you're worried might not work with einkorn. To know that I am not diagnosing, I am not prescribing anything in this episode, I'm just kind of giving you an idea of certain things that you might want to look into more, okay? So first off, we have celiac. If you have celiacs, this one might be a no-brainer that you should not have einkorn, because although it is the original wheat, it is still a wheat. And I will say that there have been studies shown, there's been things shown that say that einkorn does not cause as much of a reaction as modern day wheat for those who have celiac. And I will put a link to some of the information on that. You can also look back at, I believe it's one of my einkorn blog posts, possibly one of the videos. I'll try and put a link down below for that one, or if I figure it out. If I figure it out, I will put it up here as well so you can link back and see what information I have on that here. So it doesn't cause as much of a reaction, but it will still cause somewhat of a reaction, and that is because even though the structure is a little bit different than modern wheat, it still has the same DNA structure of wheat. It is still wheat. And yes, it is the original wheat. It's what wheat first began as. And our modern day wheat has come so far from that, that in a lot of instances, you know, our bodies just don't take it on well. And we've seen just this huge influx of people with what we call celiac. In the last, what has it been, 40 years or so. And so if for some reason that is you, einkorn is not supposed to be something that you can tolerate. I'm sorry. But just know that people are still working. There are still a lot of researchers working, and there's still a lot of people who are trying to see if there is some way that those with celiac can end up being able to take on something like einkorn. In fact, I did read an article on that as well. I'll try and link that below too. But just know that where we are today is not where we will be 5 years from now, 10 years from now, okay? So there's always new things coming out in the medical world, and so there is hope. Okay, number two is certain autoimmune disorders. Now, I say this, and I really want you to think about this one a lot harder. You might need to do more research with it. We have a son who has had an autoimmune disorder, and he actually does not anymore. And I will probably post out another video on that very soon, because he had PANDAS and he does not have PANDAS anymore. Thank you, God. And so we have made it through that. But when he had PANDAS, he was on a very strict diet because of certain foods that would cause a reaction for him, and we were really watching inflammation in his body while trying to get through the PANDAS, his autoimmune disorder. And because of inflammation, because of reactions that the body will have to certain foods, a lot of people with autoimmune disorders will have this autoimmune sort of reaction to foods. And because of that, they'll take the foods out. And so that's what we were doing, and wheat was one of those. But I will also say that there have been people with autoimmune disorders who have been fine using Einkorn. In fact, I believe I've read comments from people with Hashimoto's who have been able to use it and have said that their autoimmune numbers were not raised after they incorporated the Einkorn in. And again, I am not a practitioner. I'm not a health practitioner. So, you know, this is something for you to do your own research on and talk to your doctor. As a wheat though, Einkorn is wheat, but it is definitely different than our modern wheat. And that in itself is why some people are able to tolerate it. Their bodies are able to tolerate a little bit better than the modern day wheat. So because of our son's autoimmune disorder, that was what really got me into a lot of the homestead stuff. We got ducks because he couldn't do the chicken eggs. I started growing a lot of leeks because he couldn't do onions. I mean, there was just all these things, and you can see that in my homesteading for autoimmune disorders, or I think I called it homesteading for special diets video. You can get some ideas if you are trying to work a special diet into your family on how to do that using homesteading and raising your own food. That had been just a very helpful thing for us, and it still is, and it's given me a lot of growth in the area of gardening and just homesteading altogether. Okay, number three. This one takes in a lot because it really just has to do with having some kind of a cleansing diet for either fungal issues, could be mold or mycotoxin issues, yeast issues, kind of like fungal issues. Some kind of a cleanse where you are trying to cleanse something out of your body or multiple things out of your body to clean it out and detox. And usually with these sorts of diets, you will take most, if not all, grains out of your diet. And yes, that includes Einkorn. Even though it is so amazing, believe me, your body will be able to heal a lot better in some circumstances if you just take out the grains. And so if you are trying to heal from something like a yeast infection, you know, then you are going to want to have to follow what the diet say for that, and don't try and get away with adding a little bit of Einkorn in with it, because you'll probably have a lot quicker recovery. You'll have a lot better cleansing if you do go ahead and follow those certain diets that say, no, you need to take out the grains, you need to take out all of this. So go ahead and follow that. And the especially nice thing about those diets are they are not a forever thing. They are a circumstantial thing, and it doesn't last. And so they are only for a season, and then you can go ahead and incorporate your Einkorn back in. SIBO, the GAPS diet, both of those are also diets that usually require, you know, all of the grains to go out. You're looking at grains, dairy, sugars, those types of things are usually eliminated in these types of diets. How to see if Einkorn will work for you. So above all, talk to your doctor. And it doesn't really help if your doctor doesn't know what Einkorn is, I will say. So it's great to talk to a trusted doctor who is knowledgeable about wheats, such as Einkorn and our modern day wheat, and kind of knows the difference. That does help. Take notes when you add it in on any reactions you notice, anything different during the day. Keep a paper nearby in the kitchen. You can put it up on the refrigerator and a pencil nearby so that you can take notes during the days. Make sure you write down dates too, and also keep notes on how much Einkorn and when you are eating. Those three things right there will be great for helping you understand how your body is reacting to it, as well as following up with your medical practitioner and seeing if you need to do any tests to see if it's reacting with your body as well. If you are able to do Einkorn and you are a beginner, I do recommend you look at my beginner Einkorn sourdough bread. That recipe is super easy. There's not a lot of kneading, folding, or anything. It's basically just putting the ingredients together and waiting for it to rise a little bit and then baking it. And if you have not yet subscribed to the channel, would you please do that? Click the subscribe button And it really does help this channel be seen by more people on YouTube because they start to recognize it as something that people are wanting to see. And I thank you guys for those who have subscribed and are following. And let me know where you are on this Einkorn journey. Are you not able to have Einkorn at all? Have you been able to incorporate it? And if you have an autoimmune disorder, that would be really neat to know too, if you have been able to incorporate it with your autoimmune disorder. So let me know in the comment box below, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.